Fiona, my little lovely hippo cutie. My love for you is bigger than my big old hippo booty.
One adorable zoo creature certainly doesn't mess around when it comes to his playtime. This is Balam, a jaguar at the San Antonio Zoo. Staffers caught him on camera enjoying the toy and turning it into a makeshift swing.
We were talking about the San Antonio Zoo. They had like this sort of a revenge book, right? And you could announce your exes and name them after a cockroach. And they also had rats that you could name after.
You feed them to snakes.
The San Antonio Zoo is holding a fundraiser in which you can name a cockroach after your ex and watch an animal eat it on Valentine's Day for just $5. By the way, that scene is also in the director's cut of Marriage Story. By the way, naming a cockroach after your ex and watching it devoured is a perfect way to say, screw you, Stacy. And also, you clearly made the right choice, Stacy.
Really? Really? Man, I feel bad for the cockroaches. They can survive a nuclear war, but they can't survive Alan and Janet's Saturday at IKEA. Really?
Been working on this for almost 5 years now.
Now to growing concerns about the deadly coronavirus officially hitting the U.S.
And developing right now at noon, the city of San Antonio now says we have our first confirmed case of coronavirus.
Midnight tonight, San Antonio Mayor Ron Nuremberg and Bexar County Judge Nelson Wolf are ordering all individuals within city and county limits to stay at home and only leave their homes to perform allowed activities.
And if you were hoping to take the family out to the zoo this weekend, it is time to make new plans. The zoo closing their gates this weekend amid the coronavirus pandemic.
Carousel at a standstill.
The gates closed, no money to help feed the animals.
CEO Tim Morrow had to shut down the zoo March 14th.
It is shut down.
First couple days were, it was a peaceful quiet, and then it became eerie very quickly.
And animals now wondering where all the curious faces have gone.
The San Antonio Zoo says it is forced to furlough its staff.
The zoo has furloughed more than half its staff.
Furlough.
And the result?
The word I've been using is catastrophic.
The nonprofit has had to furlough many of its staff in ticket sales, restaurants, and guest services.
It costs about $2 million a month to operate the zoo.
The zoo is just very expensive to operate, between $300,000 and $500,000 a week to operate without guests here. So now donations are more important than ever.
The San Antonio Zoo is donating perishable food to Haven for Hope. The donation comes after the zoo closed its doors temporarily because of the outbreak. Due to the closure, they had fruits, meats, dairy products that they didn't want to go to waste, so they did a pretty cool thing and donated it all to Haven for Hope.
April Fools, the San Antonio Zoo played a prank on San Antonio media Wednesday, including us here at KSAT 12. We got fooled into thinking they actually took their elephants to the San Antonio River for a swim.
A very special lady at the San Antonio Zoo just celebrated her 60th birthday. It's Lucky the Elephant. And there was a big party in her honor. That she had a cake made out of fruit and vegetables.
We have a big birthday shout out to give this morning. Timothy the hippo at the San Antonio Zoo turns 5 today.
When you think of a drive-through, you probably don't think of heading to the zoo. But that's what the San Antonio Zoo is hoping families will do this weekend. Zoo officials are calling their new drive-through zoo a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Quarantine while, a Texas zoo is opening back up to the public with a drive-through experience. From the security of inside their vehicle, visitors will be able to see lions, tigers, and bears. Oh my. This is great news for anyone who's ever thought, I wish birds weren't the only animals pooping on my car.
Backed by popular demand, the San Antonio Zoo extending dates for its drive-through experience. Families can return in their vehicles this coming Monday through Thursday.
The Tim Duncan Foundation teaming up with the San Antonio Zoo to thank frontline workers. They're providing dozens of zoo gift baskets to workers at the San Antonio Food Bank, University Health System, and Methodist Healthcare.
Now, next weekend, the San Antonio Zoo, they will welcome back members and other pass holders. General admission, though, will start on June 1st.
But you do have to make a reservation, and the time slots will be staggered, clearly to practice social distancing.
A woohoo for this. Check this out. The San Antonio Zoo says there's been a bit of a baby boom going on. Newborns making their debut there at the San Antonio Zoo. There's a southern tamandua, otherwise known as the collared anteater. That's him right there. That is weird and cool.
San Antonio Zoo, Walmart, and Centro San Antonio teamed up to make sure downtown remains beautiful. Volunteers helped replace broken pots that were damaged during recent protests. Well, Walmart provided the plants, and the zoo horticulture team helped with their expertise.
After working on it for more than 18 months, the San Antonio Zoo has released a graphic design now for their parking garage. It'll feature a Sumatran tiger, four monarch butterflies, and signage for both San Antonio Zoo and Brackenridge Park.
Caught on camera, kittens and puppies visiting the San Antonio Zoo. Now that zoo paired up with an animal shelter to host some of their adoptable pets. Look at them. Come on. They live streamed the visit, and why not? Because this is social media gold. You can see the animals just kind of scoping each other out, getting a feel for one another.
San Antonio Zoo sending some unusual art critics off on a special mission.
So they weren't just any critics, they were more like critter critics. Take a look. A few of the zoo's animals took a trip to an art museum in Texas, and while many took some time to admire the art, look at the snake, others enjoyed slithering or running around the empty halls.
It's an exciting time for the San Antonio Zoo as they hatch a rare bird for the first time in 5 years. Micronesian kingfishers are extinct in the wild, and there are only about 140 in human care. The chick's parents were introduced in March, and apparently the birds are very picky about their partners, but this pair hit it off right away.
This is at the San Antonio Zoo. Watch closely. Apparently their tongues are 2 feet long. They have the longest relative tongue to their body size of any mammal. So is that the tongue we're looking at?
Are you sure that's not a vacuum cleaner?
The San Antonio Zoo is finding a new way to connect with zoo supporters this year amid the pandemic. The zoo is holding its annual gala tonight at 7, and it will be completely virtual. The Roaring Twenties Zubilation Ball benefit is more important than ever following the zoo's extended closure and decreased number of visitors.
The San Antonio Zoo is giving animal lovers a chance to really help them pave the road to recovery. They're creating a one-of-a-kind design featuring a jaguar, and you can be part of the piece of art. For a limited time, zoo supporters can buy a paver.
The San Antonio Zoo packed up and headed off this morning to help the Alexandria Zoo in Louisiana after it was impacted by Hurricane Laura. They'll get there with the help of fuel cards donated by Valero Energy and are using construction equipment offered up by United Rentals.
The Will Smith Zoo School, the San Antonio Zoo, getting a huge boost. Today, the Texas Cavaliers donated $1,050,000 to the school. School officials say that money will be used to help them reach a goal of having 30% student enrollment through tuition assistance. Members of the Texas Cavaliers say the pandemic made it hard to raise money, but they still got the job done.
What did the hyena say about the lion? We can have whatever's lying around.
So today we're presenting a check for $10,000, and that's split between us and our distributor partner, Silver Eagle. And this came from the sales of conservation over the 2019 year. And so now we're working on the 2020 year, and we're getting ready to roll out a 2021 can in January.
A milestone today, the first time Texas horned lizards have been released into the wild. First, the lizards had a health inspection shortly before their release just west of Llano. More than 80 lizards.
Hey, I want to give props to the San Antonio Zoo here. They've just announced their inclusion in the American Humane's inaugural feature-length documentary, Escape from Extinction.
Well, you want to support somebody in the race for president, very non-controversial maybe. Timothy the hippo At the San Antonio Zoo, we are told that he has announced he is running for president. Now, he has a platform that has to be very big and strong to support him. He supports naps for all, mandatory snack time at schools and offices, taking care of animals and each other, and more 24-hour buffets.
Another cool thing going to happen at the San Antonio Zoo. It's called On a Stick Festivals You Missed.
Yeah, so this is if you missed all the other festivities that should have happened in 2020.
Oh, an event that has not been canceled. Thank goodness. The San Antonio Zoo is kicking off their annual Zoo Boo, and they're going to have a drive-through Zoo Boo new this year.
On what holiday in 2020 did the San Antonio Zoo let patrons name a rat after their ex before feeding it to a snake? New Year's Day, St. Patrick's Day, April Fool's Day, Valentine's Day.
Okay, I'm guessing it's Valentine's Day. If it's not, I agree.
So I'm going to say
Valentine's Day.
E, Memorial Day.
No, not a choice.
Sorry, okay. D, Valentine's Day, that they fed a rat to a snake there. It's a final answer, Jimmy.
And final now answer. I'm going to take a sip of water. It's right. Yeah, that's right. On Valentine's Day.
Well, the San Antonio Zoo is hosting their annual Whataburger Zoo Lights. It gets underway tonight at 5:30, and the experience is COVID-19 safe. Funds will help the zoo get back on track after taking a hard economic hit during the pandemic.
In these difficult times, nonprofits have had to get creative to survive, and the award for creativity goes to none other than the San Antonio Zoo. My congratulations to Tim Morrow and his team.
And every other zoo in the world, man, step your game up, because you're all looking up at the San Antonio Zoo.
Step your game up.
And their live stream. I can remember for the longest time it was like, San Diego Zoo, San Diego Zoo, best zoo ever. Nothing like the San Diego Zoo. LA Zoo. Not at all. The bar has been raised.
Hi, my name is Tim Morrow, President and CEO of San Antonio Zoo. Like many of you, as a child, I grew up in Texas playing with lizards and snakes and bugs and enjoying the outdoors. And what San Antonio Zoo is doing now is trying to keep that alive for my children and yours. We recently held our first ever release of Texas horned lizards back into the wild, and we're more excited than ever about this project that will keep this species around for generations to come.
This is a huge milestone for our program. We're finally at the point where we have enough captive-born lizards. We're going to release 84 lizards today.
We started from scratch 3 years ago. We've been learning as we go. Finally this season, we had enough lizards and a wonderful ranch that had been managed to produce enough suitable habitat for release that we're out here doing it.
Seeing the lizards out there and hopefully coming back and seeing more, this is great. I'm super excited.
This little baby horned lizard, he was born in July. All of the lizards that we're releasing today have been screened by our vet staff. They're all healthy. I'm going to let him go because he wants to go. I want to see this lizard again in a week. I want to see this lizard again in 3 weeks. I want to see this lizard again next spring. They're just really precious to us because they're the first. So
So as best we can tell, humans played a role in the disappearance of these species with the introduction of fire ants, pesticides, things like that. And likewise, humans are going to be part of bringing this species back. Texas horned lizards were everywhere when I was a child. And it's why I became a biologist. And they're not around anymore, so I feel like a part of my childhood is gone, but my son is with me today and he released a horned lizard, and it's a good day. My hope for the future, especially with Texas horned lizards, is that their future is brighter than their past has been.